Hello students, today we have taken to discuss factorization by middle term splitting. Now you have already got factor theorem, so you know how to find factors. Now here, by the help of middle term splitting, how can we factorize a quadratic polynomial? Today let us know. So let us begin. We took the standard form of a quadratic polynomial. What we want to do, we want to find the factors by a definition or term called middle term splitting. So let us consider, if we factorize this, at the end we get like this, px plus q into rx plus s. Let us assume, if we factorize this, we get two factors at the end. Now what we do, let us multiply the left hand side and we compare the coefficients and will conclude something. Now why we are doing? For one purpose, what is the concept of middle term splitting? Otherwise the thing will be, we have to memorize. This is the thing always we will do, always we will plus, we will minus, we will multiply. This is why. So for that concept, we shall do this thing. Let us simplify. The left hand side will remain same always. Okay, so multiply. P R x square P S x Q R x plus Q S A x square plus B x plus C. Now let us try to arrange in this form. At first x square, then term containing x, then the constant. This is the term containing x square, so this is P R x square. If we take x common, I will write ps plus qr into x plus qs. Now they are equal, so the coefficients of x squared on the left hand side and the coefficients of x squared on the right hand side will be same. So here a equal to pr square, b equal to ps plus qr, constant is equal to qs. Okay student, so A equal to PR, we are just comparing, A equal to PR, this coefficient of x square, then coefficient of x, it is B and it is PS plus QR, it is constant C and it is QS. Now let us do one thing. Okay, this is, sorry, this is P equal to this, C equal to this, we got. Now what to do here? What is AC? PR into QS. Okay, this into this. Now let us arrange them. How will arrange? In this form, PS, this P into S into Q into R. Okay, so this product of these is equal to two factors. Which two factors? Here you see PS and QR. Here it appears that it is there that sum of these two factors equal to D. So in a what is the conclusion? When we will factorize a quadratic polynomial by middle term splitting, the product of the coefficient of x square and the constant, we shall arrange in such a way the factors that their sum is equal to the coefficient of x. This is the concept of middle term splitting. Okay student, now what we do, let us practice few sum. Okay, here we took this question, 9x square minus 22x plus 8. What we have to do? We have to factorize. So let us write the question in the solution part. 22x plus 8. Now what is the concept we learn? We shall multiply these two. 9 8 is 72. Okay, later on we will do the prime factorization of that. 9x square we shall arrange. How will arrange? The sum of the factors will be here plus 8, sum of the factors. Okay, now student, listen carefully. Here a shortcut method I want to tell. What is that? If the first condition is that if the coefficient of x square is positive, then only we can apply my shortcut method. Again I am saying, if the coefficient of x square is positive, then if this term is positive, always it will be positive or plus. If it is minus, you have to put minus here. You can try it in any sum. Condition is that this should be positive. Okay. Now, here, what are those two factors? Those two factors we can find from here. 236, 218, 293, 3 ja. So we have to make 22. 33 ja, 9, 9 to ja, 18. 18 plus this 4. Let us write. You have to make it. How? It is 22. There are so many options you will get, but sum should be 22. 9x square minus 18x minus 4x plus 8. From this. What is common? From these two terms, 9x is common. X minus 2. Now from here, what is common? 4 is common. What will be left? X minus 2. Now from these two terms, what is common? X minus 2 is common. So what will be left? 9x minus 4. Got it? In this way, we can factorize. Now let us take one more example. We have to practice so that this factorization by middle term splitting we can easily understand. Okay, so let us take one more example. Here we have taken one more question to factorize. Here you see, interestingly, we have taken this sign is minus. So let us see. So let us start factorization. Let us write the question at first. 2x square minus x minus 39. The coefficient of x square is positive. So as the shortcut method, I said it should be negative. Some of you may be confused, sir, why negative? You have said that in the concept always plus. Suppose 2 and 3 are two factors. We can write like this. 2 and minus 3 may be also factor. So it is 2 plus minus 3. So it is not there. We have to put plus. We can put minus also there because plus minus, because minus is also minus 3 is also a factor here. Okay. Now let us come to this point. What is the concept? We shall multiply the coefficient of x square and the constant. 39 into 2. How much? 78. Let us do the prime factorization. 2 into 39. This is 3. 13. So by subtracting we have to make 7. How? 13 and 2, 3 is 6. 13 minus 6. 2x square minus 13x plus 6x minus 39. Okay, dear student. Here you see, you made two pair. From the first pair, what is common? Only x. Twice x minus 13 plus. What is common? Only 3 is common. Twice x minus 13. Students, always remember, these two must be common. Must be same. So from here, you see twice x minus 13, twice x minus 13 is common. It's same, so let us take common. So x plus into x plus 3. So this is the factorization of this. Now let us take one more example. Okay, I have took the third example. We have to factorize this. You see, it seems a little bit different. Okay, don't worry, we can factorize very easily. Let us write the question. 3x square plus 11x plus 6 root 3. Okay, let us write in the standard, in the usual form. This is positive and this is positive, so it is plus. If it is minus, we have to put minus. Now, here we have to put two factors. What is the condition? We shall multiply this term and this term. Root 3 into 6 root 3. Root 3 into 6 root 3. So, this is 6. This is 6. Root 3 into root 3 is 3. 6 is 18. Got it, student? Now, let us do the prime factorization of 18. 2, 9, ja, 3, 3. Now, by adding, we have to make 11. How? 3, 3, ja, 9, and this 2. 3, 3, ja, 9 plus 2. Okay. Root 3x square plus this is 9x plus twice x plus 6 root 3. Got it, student? Now you watch. How can we take common? This is one pair, this is another pair. Now question is, what is common? Obviously x is common, here obviously 2 is common. Now you see, this part I want to solve here so that you can understand easily. Root 3x square plus 9x. Student, you see, we have written there. root 3 x square. 9 equal to how much? As a product, 3 into 3 into this x. Root 3 x square. These 3 let us write. Now these 3 can be written as root over 3 into root over 3 into x. 3, you see their product is 3, so 3 can be written as root 3 into root 3. Now from these 2, what is common? My dear, what is common? Root 3 and x. If root 3 x is common here, what is left? X. This root 3 and x is common. What will be left? 3 root 3. Okay, so from here, what is common? Root over 3 into x. This x will be left plus. From 9, we took root 3 common. So what will be left? 3 root 3. This x. And from these 2, what is common? Obviously, 6. Sorry, 2 is common. X plus. From 6, 2 is taken common. 3 root 3. So this x we have already taken common. And sorry. Okay. Now, you see, this term and this term. From these two terms, what is common? X plus 3 root 3. X plus 3 root 3. Okay. This is taken common. So what is left? Root 3x plus 2. But what is different? So in this way, you can factorize easily. I hope you understood. Thank you so much.